Hi guys, it's Coach Steiner from DRS Athletics, and this is DRS Strong week 283. The focus of the week is, how strong are you compared to your body size? Nerd out with me just for a second, maybe more than a second, but check it out. So the focus is for you guys to realize how strong you really are or how strong you need to get in order to feel better in the workouts or in your sport or during fitness or anything that you do. Now, relative strength is pretty much how strong you are compared to your body size, right? So it's all relative when you think body weight, your own body weight. So I'm gonna give you an example. Check it out. 100-pound person, a 200-pound person. You have a 150-pound barbell and you have to move that through the workout. Who's gonna probably move it better and faster? Probably a 200-pound person, because mass moves mass. Now, if that person didn't have the capacity, technique, or any type of training, you don't know if that's gonna move it fast. Now, it's kind of hard to tell because it's right through the middle, so you're not really measuring relatively to their body weight. Now, if you were to do that same workout, but the body weight of both is taken into consideration for how heavy they need to be going, then now it's a fair game. So even though in the world of weight, this person might be doing lighter weight, it's still heavy for them because that's body size. And even though this person's doing higher weights, it's still relatively to their size. So who's gonna win? That's gonna depend on capacity, strength, how good of a shape you are, how good and technical you are moving that weight. And it also is gonna depend on other movements within the workout. That's why am I explaining this and why we're nerding out on this, is because it's super cool to see a few things. A lighter person lifting pretty relatively heavy weights and able to continue moving, right, without having to compare themselves to someone that is 40 pounds heavier and still moving the same weight as they are, but faster, right? You're like, oh shoot, well yeah, they have 40 pounds on you. And also it's awesome to see that heavier person moving relatively heavier weight, but to themselves, still continuing to move, because even though they have bigger size, they're still agile enough and in shape enough to continue moving. In the fitness, in the sport of fitness, in CrossFit, we just can't worry about weight. We have to worry about moving our own body weight. In gymnastics, being able to run, being able to jump, being able to do other skills that is just not weight. So it does balance out why we do certain set weights, like the 135, the 95, the 95, the 65, right? Those are set weights that are meant for everyone to be able to move at one point in the RX prescription, but it all levels out, because even if someone that is heavier moving that weight faster, they might have a harder time in other movements that will balance out that person that's lighter and not moving those weights as fast, but they might be able to catch on a run or something gymnastic. So it's good that we practice all our different spectrums of fitness, so that way you're not just stuck in thinking weight, but you have to be overall in good fitness shape, right? So let's hit it, let's go!